Good morning, guys. So let's finish with chapter one and maybe start talking about chapter two. You guys already a quiz. This quiz, you can find it in Canvas. And every quiz, actually, you're going to be able to find it in Canvas if you go to assignments. It's not in quizzes, all right? Because these are quizzes that I made. They are not multiple choice. Oh, they are, but they have also open-ended questions. So it's open already and it's due in 10 days from now. Don't expect every quiz to be like that. Since the course just started, I published this quiz, but quiz number two, for example, will be due October the 5th. And then you see there are less days available for quizzes. So please keep in mind this calendar. I'm willing to give maybe a day of extension or so, but the quizzes are not very difficult and the information will be found in the slides, in the book, and the videos, right? So there are a few things I want to go over today. When we talk about astronomical distances, and even when we start talking about science in general, physics, astrophysics, we need to be comfortable with powers of 10. So it would be a good idea if I show you guys very briefly how to multiply and divide numbers in powers of 10. So the only thing that you need to know, and it's also in the slides, is when you multiply. So if you multiply a number like 3 × 10^5, this can be meters, right? We multiply by another big number, 2 × 10^10, right? This can be units of meters, kilometers, miles, right? So in astronomy, you have very large numbers. So how do you multiply numbers that are like this? The way you're gonna do it is by saying 3 × 2 = 6 × 10^5, 10^10. You add the exponents. This will give you 6 × 10^15. You see what I did here, right? I multiply the numbers. I got 6 and then I did law of exponents. That's basically your law of exponents. All right. Now let's try to divide. So if we try now and divide numbers that are in scientific notation, right? This is scientific notation, so I can do 4.8 × 10^21 divided by 1.6 × 10^12. So you can use a calculator for this. But if you do the division here of those two numbers, you will get 3. And what do you do when you have exponents like 10^21 divided by 10^12? You subtract 21 minus 12, right? So here will be 10^9, whatever, right? That's basically what you have to be comfortable. That's one of the mathematics that you need to be comfortable. Of course, in very small numbers, when we deal with very small distances, let's suppose you have 700 nanometers. We're gonna talk about more than nanometer in chapter 5, when we talk about optics and telescopes. But this is basically 700 × 10^-9 meters. So 2 zeros, right? You do 7 × 10^-9 plus 2 zeros, -7 meters. Now, what do you do if you now, so now you are going to do 7 × 10^-7, you are going to multiply this now by 2 10 to the power of 3. So how do you work with numbers? It's the same. 7 times 2 is 14. But you need to remember your integers, right? Minus 7 plus 3 is what? 10 to the negative 4. So you're going to be able to go back and forth in the recording, but remember, these are basically operations with integers, right? So here, any negative number, when you add a positive number, you subtract and you get the sign of the largest number. What's the largest number? 6. So then it's minus 2. All right. Let's check the division. The division will have, for example, here, 5.2 times 10 to the negative 10 divided by 1.4 times 10 to the negative 20. So that is a much smaller number than this. So when you divide this, if you do this in a calculator, you will get, let me change this to make it a whole number. You will get 4.2 divided by 1.4 is 3. How do you subtract here? So 10 to the negative 10 divided by 10 to the negative 20 is 10 to the negative 10 minus minus 20. That gives you effectively 10 to the 10, right? Negative and a negative is a positive. So 20 minus 10, 10. So here, 3 times 10 to the 10, that will be the answer of that. All right, make sure that you review that. The other thing I wanna go over is the circumference and the small angle approximation that is in the slides. And with that, we will be finished with chapter 1. I just wanna introduce the idea of an astronomical unit that we use as a unit of measurement within a solar system, right? But before we talk about that and the parsec, let's have this. A circle has 360 degrees or 2 pi radians, right? So a circle has 360 degrees or 2 pi radians. And then remember, 1 degree is equal to 60 arc minutes, and 1 minute is equal to 60 arc seconds, right? Therefore, 1 degree is equal to 3,600 arc seconds. All right, that's how we convert units. And we use that because a lot of the distances and positions in the night sky are measured using degrees, minutes, and seconds. If you're doing the lab portion of this course, you will see that in Stellarium, we measure, there is something called the angle measure tool. That's what it's based on. We can have, and actually, let's show you the celestial sphere, right? The celestial sphere is basically placing the Earth. And then you have a sphere all around it. So with the center here, we can start locating constellations. Cassiopeia looks like a W. You can have Lyra there. And you can have Polaris right on the zenith in the Little Dipper. So we can find positions in the sky by knowing and actually distances, right? So this distance here, this will be measured in degrees, minutes, and seconds. All right, so this is the Earth. We start looking at different Cassiopeia. So that's basically what we use. That's why we use the small angle approximation, right? But when we talk about a solar system, you know, the distance between the planets and the sun, and then between planets, we introduce the astronomical unit. So for that, let's share the slides. So this is the small angle approximation. That's how we measure with our hand. We can actually estimate angular distances. It can be in the northern hemisphere with a little deeper, or in the southern hemisphere with a southern cross. You guys use the northern, little deeper, and Polaris to know where the north is. In the south, we use Alpha and Beta Centauri and the southern cross to locate the south celestial pole. So that's important there. That's what we just talked there. And then this is your powers of 10, right? You can go from the size of an atom to the size of a galaxy. So that's why you have big numbers. This power of 10 or scientific notation. So there you are. What you need to know is we don't use kilometers, miles in space, in astronomy. We use astronomical units. We use light years. We use parsecs. Astronomical unit is the average distance from the Earth to the Sun. Why the average? Because we will learn in the next chapters that the orbit of the Earth around the Sun is not a circle. It looks almost like a circle, but it's actually an ellipse. And that will be actually described later using Kepler's laws and Newton's laws. But just for you guys to know, it's approximately 93 million miles. A light year is the distance that light takes to travel in 1 year. Remember, the speed of light is huge but finite, and it's approximately 63,000 AUs. So clearly that goes for distances that are interstellar, right? For example, the distance from the sun to Alpha Centauri, right? The closest star to a solar system that is like the sun is approximately 4.3 light years, right? But then we measure distances within the solar neighborhood, and also in the Milky Way, we can also use light years. However, as we explore the universe more and more, right, we need to go into a higher unit. And maybe later on, we will have to get another one when we start getting larger distances, right? So we introduce the parsec. The idea with the parsec is very interesting. It's here. Imagine you are an observer and you move away. And you move away from the Earth orbit as is shown in the picture, in such a way that the angle between the Earth and the sun, and I'm talking about the Earth orbit and the sun, is exactly 1 arc second. The thing is, depending where you are, you can look at the distance between a planet and a star or another planet at a higher angle, right? It's like when you are looking at the top of a building. As you get closer, you have to go like this, right? More steep. As you go farther, the angle decreases. So it's the same like this. As you go farther from the Earth-Sun orbit, you can actually decrease the angle up until you get 1 arc second. We measure that that distance is equal to 1 parsec, approximately 3.26 light years. That's why it looks like a random number, right? But it's not. It actually has some science. It actually has science behind this, right? So then we can actually use parsecs to do a few measurements, right? We know that the distance between the Earth and the center of the Milky Way is approximately 30 kiloparsecs. So 30,000 parsecs multiplied by 3 is approximately 100,000 light years, right? So we get to that point, right? Where we can actually use numbers to simplify the units of measurement, right? So this is a nice diagram to show you guys in kilometers or in AUs, certain distances like the diameter of the Earth, the average distance between the Earth and the sun, and or maybe the distance from the center of the Milky Way to the sun, all right, in light years, right, in light years. All right. The key ideas are always very important. You can always go here and check the summary of the of chapter 1. So I'm gonna cut the video here and I will make video for chapter 2. I will try to upload it by tomorrow Saturday. Okay. So use this video and the first video to study for chapter one. All right. Chapter two, we'll start talking about knowing the heavens. So here is where we're going to start talking about constellations, why astronomy is important, how we take measurements, evidences of astronomical observations in the past. Stonehenge is pretty good. This here, where I was last year, Chichen Itza, right? The Mayan temple, the Egyptian pyramids, right? And how we actually get the names of some of these constellations thanks to the Greeks. All right. So I hope that you actually enjoy this when we start talking about this. All right, guys. So I'll leave it there and I will see you guys later. Okay. If you have any questions, feel free to send me an email. Okay. Have a good rest of your day and goodbye.